Hi, Phil Taylor here, AdWords strategist, and in this video we're going to look at AdWords location targeting. That is how to narrow down the users that you show your ads to based on their location. So I'll show you exactly how to set up location targeting and then how to make it work effectively for your campaigns. So first, why would you only want to show your ads to users in certain places? Well, in some cases, the answer might be obvious. Let's say you're a local business and you only serve customers close to you, then you're only going to want to try to convert users who are close enough either to get to you or for you to get to them. But then even when there's no obvious location preference based on your product or service, you'll still find location targeting useful. And the reason for that is that, as with other AdWords variables, once you start to accumulate data, you'll find patterns emerge showing some areas that work well and some areas that work less well. And then you can use that data to put your budget towards the places that are profitable for you to target. So for that reason, location targeting is really a useful feature for all AdWords campaigns. Now, the first thing to note about setting location targeting is that it's done at the campaign level. Other user-based variables like demographics or devices can be set at the ad group level, but locations are campaign level. So the first thing we'll do is grab the specific campaign that we want to set targeting for. There's only one campaign visible here, that's Loki's Local. And once you've clicked on that, you could enter locations on the left nav. So from this screen, the location screen, you can see the different locations that are being targeted. So again, there's only one here, that's United Kingdom, and you can see that on this row there would be data if the campaign had any data, and you can see it as the blue area or areas highlighted on the map. And now with this icon you can add, edit or remove the locations being targeted. So let's try adding a new one. You add your locations here on this line, and you can enter them as country name or as county or a state if you're in America. It will take the first part or postcode. And as you can see, the auto suggestion is pretty good. Or you could add any other significant place name like Isle of Wight or something. And then the other way to add a location is by radius targeting. And that's where you set a more specific point and you choose the size of the radius of the circle around it that you want to target. So we're going to do that. So with this one you can add a specific postcode. Here's one that I know exists. And then you will see here on the map, when that resolves, the circle of targeting. So users within that circle should now see the ads if we save this as a targeted location. I'm going to add another location to this for reasons that will become clear later. I'm going to add Hertfordshire, which is the county within which that radius lies. And then I'm going to remove the wider UK targeting. So now you can see these two areas that are being targeted. This specific circle around the point where our fictional company is, and the county around it. Now, with the bid adjustments, you can choose to up or down weight your bids in the different locations. And you might see what's coming here. So in this very specific circle, this very tight circle around the area of the company, we're going to bid more. Let's say we think our bids are going to be worth 25% more when we're showing ads to people really close. And in Hertfordshire, it will be worth showing to users in that wider field, let's say that's what we're judging at the moment, but they will be less valuable on average. So let's downweight those bids by 10% from whatever we set at the keyword or ad group level.
Well, then, of course, as the campaign runs and we see data on each row, so for each location, we will get a sense of what's working, particularly once we've added conversions as a column so that we can see where people are converting. And that will give us an idea of what locations are working well, where we should maybe increase bids further. If ads are really not working at all in certain places, we'll remove them from the targeting list. If it does seem to work very well that we target people close by the business, then we might experiment further in that direction. We might try to even reduce the radius of the circle and target more tightly. But from now on, basically, we're sort of set up to collect the data that's going to inform our targeting decisions and our bidding against those different location targets. And the last thing to note in this intro to location targeting is that you can also, by a very similar method, exclude different locations from having people there see your ads. So if we wanted to target Hertfordshire, but we did not want people in, let's go for Stevenage, nothing personal, to see the ads, then you can enter Stevenage there, and it shows in red as an area in which people should not see the ad. Okay, so let's see if we get a nice view of that. Yeah. So, blue, people are seeing the ads. Here, this is targeted for the radius and also within Hertfordshire. And worth noting there that where you have an area within an area, when you're adjusting your bid for the wider area, that will not affect people in the inner area. So people here will genuinely get just your plus 25%. People outside of that, but within Hertfordshire, will get your minus 10% reduction. People in Stevenage now should not see the ad at all.
So that's an introduction to location targeting. Please comment or feel free to send me a message if you have any questions. And if you'd like more tips on this subject, then look out for my video on advanced location targeting. This is Phil Taylor, AdWords strategist. Until next time.